Probably you saw an ad on Facebook or YouTube that you should definitely create whiteboard animation. And now is the question if Doodly is the right choice for it. In this video, I'm going to share with you three reasons why you shouldn't use Doodly. But before that, I'm going to share with you reasons why you should use Doodly. Now, plenty of YouTube channels are using Doodly, and there is a reason for it. Only because Doodly is really simple to use. Then another thing is that with the Doodly, you can create amazing things because you can upload your own characters, your own fonts. And there is one thing comparing to the other competitors is that with the Doodly, you can do one perfect thing. So when I would upload a character, so let's say I'm going to show you right now. So I'm going to have a character. What you can do is you can actually plan how it's going to be drawn. That's perfect. And that's something that Doodly has, and many other competitors like VideoScribe, they don't have it. Now, also another thing with the Doodly, yeah, like this should be a negative video about Doodly, but I'm sharing the positive sides, but I just can't help myself. When a program got plenty of advantages, I'm going to share them too, right? So another thing with the Doodly is that if you want to use it, they got one of the best exporting options with MP4, with full HD. Yes, sometimes the rendering is really slow, but again, it's good. So definitely keep in mind if you want to use Doodly, these things out. But what are some now disadvantages? Plenty of people felt that they were being lied to, that Doodly wasn't that transparent with their pricing plans. So when you come here, you see that you got standard and enterprise. Yes, that's like the basics. Probably if you see Facebook ad, you can see also that you're gonna have like one-time payment of, I don't know, what kind of price was that, and then you don't have to pay monthly. But really keep in mind that Doodly got really aggressive upsell strategies. The more you go, the more you pay. So when you would come here, they got modules and what you can also buy. So that's something you should definitely keep in mind. And also, like, you can't use colorful characters in Doodly. So when you're gonna have a colorful character, you need to buy another add-on for like $67 or $69. And that's something to keep in mind too. So person thinks that, okay, I'm going to pay for enterprise version and I'm going to get covered everything, is not true at all. You have to actually pay more to access more things. That's like, all right, but they are not being really transparent about it, right? So also they got really aggressive emails. So that's another thing that you have to keep in mind. But other than that, it's like Doodly is fine. But this is something to keep in mind, that if you think that, okay, in enterprise version, you're gonna have everything, it's not true. Yes, you can do most of the things, but if you want to have colorful characters, more things there, you have to pay more money. But again, with the option to uploading your own characters, objects, fonts, you can really play around it as much as you want. So that's the first thing. The second thing is, yes, it's desktop application, but you need to have internet connection constantly. I know that everyone is Wi-Fi, but let's say that you would be traveling somewhere and you want to use Doodly on your notebook, you won't be able to do it. So that's something you have to keep in mind. And that's a disadvantage that I personally think is important, that let's say that I'm traveling in a train and I don't have access to the internet. So what I would need to do is to like have Wi-Fi or something. So that's another disadvantage. And then this is a huge disadvantage in my opinion, is that you cannot edit individual items such as characters and props. So when there is a character and you won't be able to change like the colors and everything of it, comparing to, let's say, I don't think even that VideoScribes offers it, Vyond offers it. So these offer it and it's like pretty good. So this is pretty much it. But again, Doodly is perfect and plenty of people are actually using it for the whiteboard animation videos, only because of how simple it actually is. Now also, Doodly doesn't offer you a way how we can record your own voice. You need to record it somewhere else like Audacity and then upload it to Doodly. Also, some people said that they had problems with linking the audio with the video singing in Doodly. But again, it's about testing and learning. I would recommend Doodly to a lot of people, but I would be just like careful about actually having the how would I call it? The upsell. You know, that if you're expecting again that you're gonna pay $67 for everything and you're gonna have everything is not true at all. You get like one-time payments in Doodly that you have to be careful about. So that's pretty much it. If you're interested, you can share with me your thoughts on Doodly if you like it or if you don't like it. And yeah, thank you and have a great day and goodbye. See ya.